bike today, Carol's bike, putting a new battery in, and putting on saddlebags, and then cleaning up all the chrome and aluminum. Bike is dingy. While I'm brewing. Yay, brew! Heating up the strike water right now. And I am brewing J Money chocolate stout. Classic American stout. So, J Money, I took your recipe. I did tweak it a little, but not much, based on a few people's, based on what Clements reviewed and what I reviewed. It was really good. I only made a really small change. I'll show that shortly. Anyway, cut in and out today, showing you the hops, growth, and a few other things. This isn't a Homebrew Wednesday video, it's just an update. So it'll be short and sweet, hopefully. If it gets any longer, it was because I threw in a tasting of the ESB. Cheers. We love your sense of humor. I had to pump in a little bit more water to get it there. It was like 153, so I ran about an extra half gallon. So, pretty close. That's actually right on, but I was pretty close to begin with. Backfilling the HLT right now. So she's backfilling after the initial infusion. Woo. So as soon as it covers that second element, I can flip the heat back on. Did it? Or is that an illusion? Yeah, it covered it. Okay, on she goes. Set my restart temp. Oops, too low. Can't really see in the sun. It's 154. And yes, back with the vice grips. It's in, at least the negative side. I gotta come back over here. Still rolling at 154. I'm about 15 minutes in on the mash. Ooh-wee, that smells... that smells incredible. That's J Money's Stout First Runnings. Fucking smells good. And the battery's in, and I mounted the saddlebag mounts. And the chrome is all polished, I just gotta rub it out. And... looks like a mocha. Yummy. Thanks, J Money, for the recipe. It's going to be delish. And we are at the boil. 2 ounces of glacier. Is vigorous. Alright, that didn't tear open, right? Pellet hops. Oh, that smells good. Let's see if this one tears right. There we go. That was better. Real mild. I think I've used glacier before, but it's been a while. I used it. I think I might have used it in a pale ale. Can't remember. It's been so long. But it's been a real long time since I've used glacier. So faint. Interesting. J-Money, I also am adding a little more hops than you had. The 2 ounces of glacier and you had 1.5 ounces of Willamette. I'm going to go ahead and add 2 ounces of Willamette. Yield it a little more with your same grain bill. Might have yielded it a little more. So. Of course, not knowing what your efficiency was, I just went with your grain bill and just figured what the hell and see where it ends up. So I'm supposed to final gravity is supposed to be around. Which reminds me. Pre-boil gravity, 1060, almost 1061. Oh, I don't know if you guys can see this. Oh, well. No need to see my face, I guess. Okay, I get SMC Brewing. The 1099 white bread. 1099 white bread is a mild, malty, and slightly fruity fermentation profile. Is less tart and dry than Y yeast 1098. Quick flocculation characteristics. Yeast clears well without filtration. Oh shit, I forgot my bottle opener. Let's see if this still works. Okay. That was a good hiss. There's a little bit of yeast settled in the neck. Got this all dried out. I'll let this warm up a little bit so it wasn't quite so cold. Paper. It's pretty clear through the pour, but it is cloudy in the glass. But not as cloudy as most. It's got a fairly good carbonation, about a millimeter or two of head, not much, but that's good. It is much clearer than some of the other ones I've seen. It's kind of got a burnt orange caramel look. You can see the bubbles rising up from the bottom. Oh yeah, I'm picking up malt character right off. A little bit of fruit, but not like a citrusy fruit, more like allergies are right off the chart. I picked up a similar profile in somebody else's beer with this. I'll have to go back to my notes. I like it. I like the profile. almost like a, like, it's almost like mango mixed with caramel. It's just a real unique aroma that I'm getting on the nose. All right, let's give it a taste. It does finish a little more dry than I have seen, but it's not bad. That's good. A slightly tart, I think, on the end. Carbonation's good. It's dancing on my tongue. I'm picking up a good malty backbone. Not as much caramel, but that's fine. I'm just... something I picked up on the nose a little, but oh yeah, there's not much back bitterness, but there's a lot of lingering malty backbone, kind of hangs around the tongue. Wow, this is a really good beer. SMC Brewing. I like this yeast profile too. I had to go replace the memory card. What I was saying was, I think if I use this yeast, I would alter the might alter the recipe a little bit to accommodate these. Add a little more hops in the bittering side to pick up where the yeast has taken away some of that bitterness in the back. It's a great beer. It just, the yeast kind of took away a lot of that back bitterness. I like it though. But for bitter, I think more bitterness in the back, and that's what the yeast did. Which is amazing to me. I never thought yeast would have that much effect on hop profile. It's just amazing. I knew it would on the nose because esters kind of can overpower hops and vice versa. But I never thought it would affect the back, you know, early addition bitterness from hops. It's crazy. And the carbonation is spot on. The color, I think, is spot on. I think you're probably a little more clear than most, but not the clearest I've seen so far. I think Dwarf might have had the clearest one so far. If this was in a bar, I think it'd be the number one seller. So far, which is a huge, you know, plus. It just lacks a little bit of the back bitterness, which I think is, I'm going to go out on a limb and say it's got to be the yeast, and maybe even your water profile, I'm not sure. Maybe your water profile is not hard enough, and that could be that too. But all in all, great beer, great brew. I'd drink more of them. I wish I had more of them. I still have some samplings due of your, I think it was your IPA, and all those cool beers you sent me. But I got to get through these ESBs first, and I'll get on those. Cheers, SMC Brewing. Great brew.
Okay, Willamette. 2 ounces. 15 minutes. Left in the boil. Well, I'm growing Willamette. Take a look at my hop plants.
All right, let's go see how the garden's doing. Oh, tomato plants. Get some beans coming up. Can't barely see them, but I've got cucumbers and whatnot. I didn't do starters on those. I just went ahead and, here we go. Looky, looky, huh? Look, they're starting to climb. I had to give them a little help to get to the wrought iron.
But these Brewer's Gold here has almost made it to the vertical rise. That's the second sprout. It's doing it equally as well. And hockey player, this is the Willamette. It was really slow to start, but she's taking off now. Trying to get it to climb, but it doesn't seem to want to climb yet. The second sprout's still not as well, but that one there is starting to take off. So, welcome back. Pretty cool. Crazy. That just takes so much time off my brew day. It's not even funny. Between the water filter and having the water connected to the brew stand all the time, and the 40 plate wort chiller, I'll tell you what, Bobby. I never showed you guys how I clean the system. Which is, I think, pretty ingenious. what I do is I fill the tank up. Okay, so I hook the water back up. I backfill the HLT. I put BW in the HLT. I stir it around. I don't run the heat. Then I run the pump. So it's running the PBW through the pump. And then I back flush. Go in the opposite direction of the way the wort was flowing. It's through the 40 plate wort chiller. Then through the coil, and so the inside of that coil, of course, gets cleaned, and then it discharges here. So I run that PBW through the system for about 5 minutes. So as that's backfilling, I'll go ahead and stir that PBW up a little bit. Oops. Oh, by the way, hockey player, the thermal probe is no good anymore. It's, it started rusting a little bit, I noticed. But, I noticed today, after I ran it for a while, my water started coming up to temp too far. It was overshooting. And when I measured it with a digital thermometer, it was 20 degrees off. So I'm going to have to replace the same one you're claimed rusted. Mine's rusting as well. All right, that's the incoming water shut off. Now I'll go ahead and you can see there's still some of that wort inside there. I'll go ahead and open that up. Boom. And hit the pump. Go ahead and I let it kind of like burp itself. And that should be good to go. And there it goes. So that's back flushing the plate chiller, all the lines, pump. The HLT really never gets dirty, but it's only ever clean, you know, just regular water, so. But the inside of the coil itself needs to be cleaned as it recirculates. So, I guess I probably should do it in the opposite direction on the coil too. Maybe do that next time. You can't get to. And just gonna clean the boil kettle and then rinse, you know, just plain old water through the system as well after. And I will be putting it away. Done. 1076, it looks like. Almost 1080. 1070. I see the 1080 there, but it's, it looks like 1076 or 1077. It's my final gravity. Holy shit.